Okay, so our recording today, just a reminder for all of you guys, what we learned last time, we need to do the sort of clips, meaning that maximum 1 hour, but we try to do a little bit shorter ones. And then the second thing is that at 12 o'clock in our time, so after about 1 hour, we need to have a lunch break because Estonia and Finland, we need to have the certain time for lunch break. And for our kitchen, we have told them that they wait a little bit longer, but it's so then they have the half an hour time for have a lunch break. So the second part, officially starting. So I hope you all guys had a awesome Christmas time and the new year. This first part, what we are going to do, we're going to go through the first module. Ah, this is difficult. Eikö tätä voi mitenkään laittaa tänne toiseen suuntaan? No kun, eikö se ei mene tuonne ruutuun? Pitäisi mun sen tällä tehdä sitten. Tänne ruutuun. Saat. So sorry about we have a problem now with the mouse. So while we are sort of waiting for the mouse to remove for the correct spot, like I told you guys last time, my name is Oona Haapakorpi, and I will be responsible for this first module what we are going to create. We, at least in Finland, we have some changes with our students. So I think it would be the nicest way that we still start introducing ourselves, and then you see the team, what is in Finland as well. So, here you go.
No.
Remember to turn to the mic.
Hello, my name is Eleonora Voinova, and I am first year cook student from Omnia Vocational College.
Yeah, my name is Patrick, and I'm a second year cook student from Omnia.
Hi, my name is Ahti. I'm a second year student at Omnia.
And our last one.
My name is Vallu. I'm a second year cook student at Omnia.
And of course, Arja is as well in here. So she will be responsible for whole team and for the cooking competition. So now I would like to go for the Vamia. Will you do the same?
Hey, I'm Kunet and I'm first year student in Vamia.
Hey, I'm Eileen. I'm first year student cook from Vamia.
I'm Lee, and I'm also the first year student in Vamia.
I'm George, first year student cook Vamia.
Michael.
And shall we go for Sigrid? We can't hear you, Sigrid.
Hello, I'm Mikael. I'm a second year chef student here at Tartu Vocational School, and happy to be here and happy to see all of you.
I'm Maurice.
My name is Shannon, and I'm a second year culinary art student at IT Tree. Hi,
my name is Eva. I'm a second year student at IT Tree.
Hi, I'm Jeremiah. I'm also a second year student at IT Tree.
Hi, I'm Mr. Skoye, student from Trinity.
Okay, awesome. So the next one, like I told you all, that I would like you to go for our Core website.
Okay, we're just having an issue here with the computers getting on. We'll be ready shortly, okay?
Okay. Am I able to start or shall I wait you guys? Maurice, shall I wait?
Yes, you can start, Oona, and we're just having a little issue here. It'll be fine. It'll be on shortly. It'll be fixed shortly.
Okay. So the first thing what I would like to show you is that the model is named Personal Branding and Marketing. And like I told you guys last time, this is the part one. It's only for tasting, for taste of the future cooking, so for competition. And as you see on our website, there is 360 photo. And this photo, it's you can roll it all over and you see the alphabets. But the first thing what I would like you to sort of have a look, it's the arrow. You can see that it's model title. And then if you click it on, you will see the whole model, what we're going to do. So personal branding and marketing, that part what we're going to do for the Cooking for the Future competition. The secondly, where I would like that you have a look, that it's the number A, and I'm going to go through for that. So all of those, the future learning teaching material, we're going to create it exactly the same way. So I just show you that you remember the next time this works exactly the same way. So like I say, from the arrows, you don't need to open the documents. You are able to see what is behind the arrows. So this is actually the document and arrow will tell you. So number one, there is always numbers. That's the way you need to start from this specific slide and all the other slides. So it will tell you that what is this slide about. Basically, this slide will tell you that it's for all of those personal branding and marketing, the material, sort of like info material, what you need to know. The second, what is most important thing for whole slideshow, it's the, I think this one that you know, firstly, there's two things what I would like you to remember. When we are creating the material, most of us, we are not native speakers. So don't mind that if there is some mistakes and what we are teaching might be native speakers, you are able to hear that we say something funny. Hopefully you don't mind. But the second thing is that when you create the material later on, like sustainable, but there is specific tasks. Do not copy directly from the web page. Remember that it's good to have a reference. Where did you took that information? Little bit change it that it's not direct copy of the document. And the second part, those icons what we are using. Always when you see, like I say, when you see the alphabet, those are the page order. And it's quite important that from every single 360 photos, it works for same way, so you know that we will start with A. And if you need to go back on some of the material, you know that we need to go A, B, or C. And then there's the parts. The parts will tell you, like in this specific, it tells at its personal branding and marketing. So it tells you the information behind it. The second icons, we use PowerPoint. As you see, it's PowerPoint, we use YouTube. And normally if you see orange color, it means that it's created through a Core project. If it's different color, it's from somewhere online. There is PDF documents, they could be PDF or Word documents, but you see the icons. This, I think it's for you all guys, one of the important things that you know that's the tasks, the things what you need to do in this specific model. And then just a reminder, that's the photo. The second icons, what you're going to see, basically the booklet, it's the model title. So it should be only in a couple of the places. It's only the information, something concerning of this specific model. And like I showed you already earlier, that arrow means info. So you do not need to click the document. Just have a look at the arrow and you see what is this specific document about. And then there is a video, the other video logo, meaning that it's from YouTube, it's from different channels, but it's video created outside of the Core, but we are using for this. And then some of the cases, there is I, which means extra information. We might have articles, we might have videos, we might have some old students' materials, what we have told you that there's the name of the students, or etc. And those are the icons what we are going to use in every single, like I told you earlier, every single 360 photos. The second part, I think that it's sort of just need to know basis. This, like you see, there is the photo behind it. And this photo is showing you that the apps, what perhaps we are going to use. I wanted to put this photo just a reminder that some people might use green screen, some people might not have green screen. That's completely okay as well. Some might use iPads, so iMovies, but Microsoft apps are fine as well. So it's up to you, the task, what we are doing. Some of them are strict, that we are telling you that you need to do exactly this way, but some of them are depending of your school, depending how do you going to create for the specific material. Today we are going to use Blocker, of course, Gmail, we're going to use Facebook, and then some of the documents depending of what we are going to use where. And the other reminder, like I told you last time, remember to take the photos while we are having these classes, so you need them later on when you need to create articles. So I think it's either teachers mainly, I think the best option is that you guys take the photos and give for your students afterwards. So this is just the introduction, and I hope you sort of understood how this 360 page work, and it's the basic information all together. So now we go for first learning teaching material actually event. Right. As you see, all the material what we are creating, we always have to have that the core as a first page. The second one is always the partners. And the third one is it's basically starting your material. In this case, it's how to use social media as a tool in personal context. For the background, I'm pretty sure that most of you, at least at the moment, you guys are now in Facebook, but most of you use some kind of apps. I think the last couple of the years, the Facebook or social media, it's really, really quickly becoming one of the most common parts of the daily life. I always keep saying that for our students, the phone is extension of the hand. Basically, phone is always there, meaning that they might perhaps taking the photos, they are chatting, they are editing for those materials, etc. So partly for that, we are now creating the professional portfolio using those same elements what most of you guys use already for daily life. I think the sites like Facebook, I know that nowadays I keep hearing for youngsters, they don't like to use it. LinkedIn, it's one of the best apps for the professional way for creating CVs. Instagram as well, if you're talking about chefs, be talking about bakers, nowadays for them, Instagram is quite highly known tool. Okay, then we have YouTube. We have different users of the YouTube. During this module, you're going to create some material for YouTube, but also for quite often the chefs, they use it for the YouTube, some of them. They either advertising, they do some kind of advertising. They show you how to create, I heard it today, they had it the bechamel session at school, or they create some kind of things over there. So nowadays, for the chefs and the bakers, I think there is nothing really hidden. You are able to learn by yourself by having a look of those YouTube channels as well. But mainly, of course, the social media, it's keeping touch with your family and friends. So what you, of course, what you need to do first in social media, you need to create the account. And again, now when we are talking about professional accounts, you really need to consider what kind of accounts you are opening, what is the purpose of those social media accounts, And what would you like? What are the outcomes? What would you like to have it later on? Mostly people just update their status, they link some materials from somebody else, you create a images or you forward to images or just your photos or videos, etc. Some of the cases you also also create, I need to ask something now. The bottom line, are you able to see it in the video as well, or should I put the hidden? Okay. So, but some of the cases people create the material also for the something related for the CV, something related to their professional life. Like you see in this right-hand side, this is Kilt School in Finnish, Kokki Kilta. This is the Omnia student page, so the Instagram account where we create different events. We have a lot of photos of the what's happening inside the Omnia, what's happening inside the kitchens, what different kind of projects we are involved with. So it's important that you sort of clearly lay out that what is the purpose of the social media for. And the other, I think, the important things when we are creating, especially when we are creating professional accounts, you need to use ads and hashtags. So ads are you using when you want direct link for the person or direct link for the some kind of web page. Hashtags, like let's say again, that sustainability, you have material what concerns the sustainability, you add hashtag for sustainability, and then somebody else perhaps are looking in Instagram, Facebook, or any other channels for this specific subject area. And now when you have used the hashtag, you will see your information and all the other information concerning sustainability. So basically, that's keywords. They are keywords of the material, what you are creating, and it allows the users find the content for relevant for them. I think that's really important. In specific, which means also you guys, when we are creating material for Facebook and Instagram, etc., we are using hashtags, cooking for the future, Kore, Kore project, Kore underlying project. Remember, if you use just a line, that does not exist. You have to use underline, so then the hashtag works. And of course, the money comes from Erasmus Plus. So we use at Erasmus Plus, and then in Erasmus world, they are happy, they are seeing that we are using that tag as well. Our Cooking for the Future Facebook site is Cooking for the Future, and it's at Cooking for the Future. So in social media, again, when we are talking about branding, and when we are talking about your personal branding, and what kind of brand you would like to create for yourself, you need to sort of think about it, what kind of material, what is personal or relevant information for you and yourself that you would like to put it in your personal account. You need to think about for platforms, what kind of platforms we are using. The platforms has to be easy, especially when you are as a starter. They have to be easy to use, not a lot of sort of new information that you need to sort of learn. They have to be flexible for iPhones or pads to use it as well. So that's one of the reasons why we have decided to use Google account and create the blog under the Google account, because according to all the statistics, that's the easiest one when you start to do for the blogging. In this example, what I have it under here, this is actually LinkedIn account, and this account is one of our, well, he has created, I think, 3 years ago. And he started the blogging, and then he went for the Instagram, and then the last part was the LinkedIn account. It's important that you show yourself. You show yourself professionally. You have decided what kind of background photos for you to use. For me personally, perhaps I would not use this one, but I know that he's really in the wild food, etc. So it makes sense. At the moment, he's co-owner in one of the restaurants in Brussels. And how did he get up there? It was that he was in a work placement for half a year, this specific restaurant, and it went so well. They asked for him to work there, and it took for 1.5 years, if I remember correctly, he became the co-owner of this specific restaurant. And one of the reasons when he was applying for this job, we had a Skype interview, and he had some materials in his blog, in the Instagram, and the owners was quite happy what they were seeing, and they was happy to say that, yes, I understand what you have done, and we are happy to work with you. Okay, so where we start? Again, when we're talking about professional image, professional branding. So like I said, most of you guys most likely take already some of the photos and post them, but they could be random photos. You take them in the free time, you take them in work placements and different events, etc. But now we are focusing only the branding yourself. So it means that you really need to think that what social media you're going to use and why do you use this specific social media? How much time you would like to spend on creating your brand? Would it be daily or would it be less than daily? It depending. It's also important that is it sort of something what you could make the part of your working life, make the part of your school life. So could you take the photo from there and use those? Perhaps I would say definitely yes. And then, of course, it's always important to make sure that you can actually evaluate that. Would it be correct way for doing that or it's just wasting my time? You will see really fast, I would say, the evaluation. You will see that like when you start to having personal Instagram account and you have proper photo and you have text and some hashtags perhaps, and you will see the other chefs, your co-workers, your student friends, they start to follow you. And then more you have valuable information, more the people will follow you. Okay, for here I put it some of the examples. As you saw already, Joni's photo in this site, and this is the other, our former students for both of them. The both of them, they started blogging, So he started in second year. And even nowadays, he is Teemu Rekranta. At the moment, he's working in Palace. So it's the one Michelin star restaurant. But one of the ways how, again, he got it there, it was the profiles, what we created. He was able to show what he has done. It was easy, the employees, to see that where he has been working, what was the work placements, what kind of projects he has been part of, and what is his interest. So he posted also the photos of the restaurants where they went, or the food, what he liked, etc. Then again, in Joni's case, as you see, it's the same photo. So he decided he will use the same photo, all the elements what he's creating for social media. So it's easy again to recognize. Again, I could say that would this green side be the best option for the blog? Perhaps not, but this was him and I'm going for it. In his case as well, he edit Omnia's logo. He has his Instagram and LinkedIn in as well. He had LinkedIn, but it's not a blog. So when you even for the blog, think about it, how would you like to be there? What would you like the people to see? And like I ask you, all of you guys, that hopefully you took the professional photos. So those professional photos has been taken in India, but they are the ones that if you see them, you completely know that where do they work? Are they the chefs? Are they the waiters? Or what are they? So this one is Instagram. And always, I would say some of you guys perhaps have already Instagram account, but most important thing when you have professional Instagram account, keep separate them. The personal Instagram account and the account what you are having for professional work. In this part, he was in the third year of our studies, and I think nowadays he has 15,000 followers or so, and this one it's much, much, much more. So we taught them quite early in the studies that it's important to take the photos, important to separate for your personal life and your professional life. And for me personally, it's quite nice that I will see he has graduated, I think, 5 years ago now, 4 or 5 years ago. He still keep blogging and he still have those two blogs. They are completely separate. In this one, he has a recommendation how could you find this blog as well. So images, remember that whatever images or well, basically photos you will take and post in the Instagram or any social media accounts, even though you would delete them, they still there. They don't sort of, they don't disappear. Someone will always find it. So be sure that your professional photos are professional. Don't create something just for fun. It's important that they are the kind of images that last for long. Okay, this page I wanted to show you that what I explained it to you for late earlier on. So we started with blogging, then we created the Instagram account, and at the last we created a LinkedIn account. And as you see on this blogger page, he has Instagram account and then he has linked that LinkedIn account as well. What you should never post, it's something that if you're really angry, do not never ever post something when you are angry. Wait for an hour or might be for a day. It's really important that you think before you post online. Read what you are sort of, what your readers would like to hear. Remember those things. Remember that there is always someone else looking for similar things, that it's important that you are specific. And you do have the followers, like I said, I believe you can create them pretty soon. So what those followers, what would they like to hear? Is it that you go for a Michelin star restaurant and then you hashtag foodie? Is it that you go for the normal restaurant? Again, you could say that it's lunch food, or are you creating lunch food? So remember the hashtag lunch food or specific time of what you are doing for that. So the last point of this one is cyberbullying. And cyberbullying, I think it's one of the important things when you start to be a part of social media, when you start to be part of the social media world. Remember, it's illegal to post from someone something which is not true. It includes, if you share the photos, if you share the text, if they are harmful, if they are false, remember that by the law, and this law is all over. So you could be cut down. So remember that whatever you are publishing, I warmly recommend that you would have a look of this link later on and have a look at what it says. So the last one, is there any questions? Is there any questions about these slides? No?
Just 1 second, Una. All right, to clarify something here.
Nämä kaksi ei voi istua sitten samassa.
Joo, ei ne.
Ne menee takapenkille.
No questions, just active discussion that everything you have put forward is valid and information, important information. So thank you.
No, all good here, Una. The lads are pretty adept at social media already. So they're... I think they all have accounts and stuff like that. It's only myself that doesn't have a social media presence. So that's okay. The students are fine.
Yeah, well, I know that most of them have social media accounts, but the main point is that you need to sort of separate your personal life and your professional life. That's the sort of really, really important thing. And what we are creating now, it's professional portfolios, professional materials. So there are a couple things that what you need to do differently when you are creating professional materials. And that was okay with Maurice? Okay. Sami, any questions? You can put the mic on and just reply.
Hello. Okay. No questions. Everything's clear. Thank you.
Okay, great. So the next one, what we're going to do, it's actually, I have already, if you go for the Facebook now, the closed Facebook page. All of you guys. So the next tasks we are doing, actually, the first one, I just want to remind you that you do remember that we have those groups that are, they call popular topics, but when you clicked, like now we are personal branding, click on personal branding and you will see for sure those tasks, what are for this specific course. So I already created the different groups. So the groups means that all of you are able to find your own group. Facebook on. Onko kaikilla Facebook? No, it's not.
Ei milk.
Is. Okay. Everyone has the Facebook on and was able to find the group.
Group.
Question now for every single one. Secret, you was able to find the group? Yes. Vamia? Sami?
Oh no, they're just checking here, Una, right?
Okay.
I'll be back to you in a second.
Yep.
For Vamia, I can't find my name, it's George. My colleagues here, George. Three of my colleagues have already their partners, but
he don't have.
Okay. Let me see, because there is couple of the, in that case, there is.
Yeah. I will contact her.
Where
like this, my
you can.
No, it's like, you see, it's white.
Only I can see that one group is unfortunately George. I see that there is one group which unfortunately it's now there.
And Una.
Yes.
Tralee here, Morris here. We have one student here that is
yes,
not.
She just did it.
She just did it. No, that's perfect. Done. Okay.
Sorry, it was my mistake. I put it because you needed last night when I was creating them. It was PM and I needed to change AM, and I think that I forgot to change it to time. So
that's
not perfect. Every single one it's able to see their names and see the groups. Yes. Yes. Okay, so and
or I wrote okay already.
You were okay. Yeah.
Okay.
I see my name. Thank you.
Good. So then I'll go. Wait. I will tell you what you need to do. It's not sähköposti.
No.
It's in Facebook. So, what you need to do in pairs, so those pairs, what I already created in the Facebook, there is the one group, I know there is three names, and for those, there is one person from Ireland, one person from Vamia, and one person from Finland. I think it's the best way that you chat about it. If you want to do it online, it's okay because it's only your group who's sort of, there is a three persons, or you could sort of chat about it through the Facebook, who is Googling who. But for sure, the first task, what you need to do, you need to find out what you are able to find for yourself. Google your own name, and then afterwards you Google the next person's name. So what are you able to find? And then those findings, either write it down or create a Word document, because I will give you 10 minutes the time to have a look what you are able to find for yourself and for your work partner. Understood? Okay for everyone? Maurice, okay, just thumbs up so I know it's okay. Okay, Sami, thumbs up if it's okay. Okay, so for you three, what is the decision? Would you like to talk or you sat? Okay, so the person, the group where was three persons, you will chat about it for whom you are looking. So I will count down for 10 minutes, meaning it's a little bit after 12:05. So you have 10 minutes time to Google those people.
Yeah,
Google. Nyt voi laittaa katse.